Hello, this is Captain Poodle speaking. Are you ready to find love?
Yes, ahoy, matey.
Love. Exciting and new. Go online. They're catfishing you.
Shocker.
Fiance.
Soon you'll be flying to parts unknown.
90-day Beyonce.
Marrying someone you only met on your phone.
Be they French or Chinese, a brand new K-1 visa's the key.
Ooh, the key to what, Poodle?
To love.
It's reality, yes, let's love.
This idea of sleeping head to toe, it doesn't matter. Your genitals are still lined up.
Oh my God, they are.
That's the Seinfeld reference. He's like, we slept head to toe. Your genitals are still lined up. Doesn't matter.
In fact, if you were
you're 69ing, you can move a little further down.
Yeah, if you're 2 minutes, it makes it a little easier.
And then I think Elaine says, but I was sleeping with my back to him. They kind of went, genitals are still lined up.
Makes it easier.
You might as well just face each other.
And besides, if you're down that way, like some guys always want to suck on my feet, so they can just do that too.
I don't want to talk about that.
I'm not into it, but they are. Whatever. I have nice feet, I've been told. Where
you
are
always,
we?
You always say that. I just go,
I don't
okay.
know what to say. I don't know what to say. Yeah, yeah, because you can't. We haven't heard enough about your creamy shoulders. Your delicate hands, or your feminine wrist, or your wily legs, or your peach-shaped ass. We haven't heard anything from the peanut gallery.
All of that is established. All of that has been written about. Copyrighted
poems
on billboards.
Poems have been exalted, yes. From
Odes have been written. I'm just saying what others, not rumors like you are saying, not someone who's so drunk they can barely say their own name. Scholars. This is toe.
This is toe.
Season 5.
Episode 5.
Episode 5. My so-called Wi-Fi.
Myself. Y'all, this episode is a 5 for 5. 5 for 5, friend. 5 for 5.
5 for 5. 5 for 5. Remember, 5, 5, say 5.
Remember where you were for 5 by 5.
Cranny, those are tampons. God, those were good times. That was a crazy season.
It was. It was not so. You guys, are you people, you ladies, you humans, whatever. We're remote but goat. So we're both in LA, but Poodle was traveling.
Went to Taylor Swift.
Well, I did go to see. I call her Tay Tay, my friend Tay Tay. I went to see Tay Tay.
What are her albums?
There are 70,000 people there, so I didn't want to give you COVID. I love her albums. I loved Red.
Keep going.
Blue. Pink.
Yeah, one of the worst things is when someone really wants to go to a concert, like me, who is actually a fan.
No, I think I'm a Swiffer now after the concert. 15. I enjoyed. That's what I said. That's what I enjoy.
You might be a... Okay, well, you know what I can tell you? If you want to become a Swiftie, you can listen to her fucking music.
I do listen to her music. I knew a lot of the songs. I know all of country Taylor, because I listened to her when she did country. So I know all of the early stuff. I knew some stuff from 1989.
Boy, what a Johnny come lately.
I liked her when she did country music. And then I enjoyed 1989. I listened to Midnight.
There were only 7 other albums.
No, I know she did. And, you know, she did them all. This was called Airs because she did things from all of her albums. I don't know if you knew that.
I'm aware. Oh. I know about the tour.
It was really great.
I've been following. Don't feel like you're having to explain it. When I saw, y'all, I
had a friend. I had a friend that went.
And she really did deserve it. She really needed to go.
She invited me.
I had been the person to go.
Well, you were out of town.
I was out of town.
You were with a gentleman friend, and I was, you know, if you were here, I still wouldn't have invited you. It would have been me.
No, you wouldn't have. But you would have gone. You would have gone.
She asked me to go. It was great. We didn't. My friend has been going through a really, unbelievably. My friend Dawn. Yeah. I posted about her on social media a lot. She's been going through some stuff, and
she had a time of it.
And her friend who works for Tay Tay again, my friend Tay Tay, works for her.
Stop saying that.
She gave us tickets, but we didn't realize. And I sent you a video. I didn't get a response from you because I just was showing you
see it.
Oh, that we were VIP tickets. So literally, we're on the very first row of the VIP. We even got to go to a separate entrance. Drinks. We got to order drinks from our own like waiter person who brought us drinks. I didn't even have to order the line. And I tried to give him a tip, and instead I gave him because my friend Don gave me that day one of those friendship bracelets. I guess that's a Tay Tay thing. I didn't understand it. But
yeah,
I gave the bartender one.
It is.
It was sweet.
It is a Tay Tay thing.
Her costumes were incredible.
Yeah,
they
were
gorgeous.
You know what? No one's been talking about it. So thank you for sharing.
I mean, she put a lot of money into this tour. I don't know if people realize that. It looks incredible. And this, we didn't realize it, but we think the one we were at was one they're taping. That's going to be the concert version, maybe, because there were cameras there and everything, and they were recording.
Are you wearing a retainer?
No, not at all. And then we were right by the, and so we were sitting there, and then I was looked over and I was like, oh, that's my friend Karamo. And so I texted Karamo and I was like,
drop the name.
And I was, well, no, this is part of this. So I was like, hey, Karamo, I see you. And he was like, where are you at? And so we were texting, and then he finally saw me, and they were down in the VIP area. And I was like, who's that woman Karamo's talking to? And he was talking to Gail King. Gail King was there 20 feet from me. And I looked over and I was like, that man is handsome. And it was this big bruiser of a man. It was Channing Tatum.
Oh.
He is monstrous in real life. He's very muscly.
Sighting.
We saw, and then Dawn was, this woman came by and Dawn waved to her. And Dawn, because Dawn was in Nashville. And so she knows people from Nashville and has mutual friends in the music industry. And so she knows about Taylor from there. And so, I'm sorry, Tay Tay. And so then Dawn sees this woman and waves at her and kind of chats with her. And then she walks away. I was like, who was that? And it was Tay Tay's mom. I didn't even know. She was beautiful. Beautiful.
Sounds like a lovely time.
It was great.
What was your dress like?
I wore just my Kennergy shirt. Dawn wore sparkles, but it was a fashion show. It was just the amount of things people made were incredible.
Girl, have you not been seeing any of this coverage?
No.
You're saying it like you came out of a cave.
Oh, it was. I've not seen it. It's not on my TikTok. It was gorgeous. What people did. It was beautiful. She sounded great. She was just so wonderful and kind and just
human. I've only been telling you this for 4 to 5 years.
You know what? I thought I'd think of her as really young. You forget her career's been 17 years. And I
No, I don't.
But it was interesting to me because
you did.
Dawn, we were talking on the way home, and I said, golly, I said, for Taylor Swift has a lot of songs about guys she dated. I said, has she really dated that many guys? Because all I knew about was Taylor Lautner, which he was there with his wife. We did see him as well.
What's wrong with you? Her whole career has been dating Hollywood men and writing songs about them.
I didn't know that. Dawn told me that this 9-minute song that she sang that was really good.
Yeah.
That was about Jake Gyllenhaal and some scarf.
Cardigan, you rube.
I didn't know. And apparently John Mayer took advantage of her when she was 19.
Yes.
I didn't know that either.
we need to move on. Everyone is screaming at you.
Well, I know that I'm not like I'm not the big Swiffer fan, Swifty, whatever they're called. But I had she invited me, so I was there to support Dawn. I had a really, really good time. I'm gonna tell people this. Take it from me, y'all. Go to this show if you can. It's a good one. It's a good one. I think it's done now, or it's gonna be, but it's worth it.
What a recommendation.
I loved it.
So you heard it first. Taylor Swift tour, Eras tour, gets two thumbs up.
Yes. It was great. Anyway, I wish you could have been there. You would have ugly cried like the 35-year-old woman standing next to me.
I can tell you that the only reason I'm not there is the Capital One presale fuck-up that happened. So that's it's a rubbing a little salt in the wounds right now because it tried to get tickets.
Oh, I didn't know you did.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. We talked
about it on the podcast, you goldfish.
Well, I would have tried to get you a ticket if you were in town. But how was Monterey? How was the aquarium? How are the otters?
They were fine. Yeah, the otters just sat there and jerked off. I watched them from my hotel window. It was actually lovely. It was a lovely trip. We went to Big Sur.
Beautiful.
Saw that. Carmel.
Did you fuck in the woods?
No. We did go to one place called The Refuge. It was kind of amazing. It was this like spa. Sissy told me about it. A bunch of sissies gave me a lot of great recommendations, and I'm going to thank them. I'm going to get back to them on Instagram. A couple sissies gave us me great restaurant recommendations, lovely drink recommendations everywhere. It was really wonderful. But this place was called The Refuge, and it was like you pay like a daily rate. You pay a day rate, and you go in, and it's like it's outside co-ed spa with like hot pools, cold plunge pools, sauna, and you kind of do the cold plunge. But it's outside, beautiful like hillside, and it's silent. Can't say anything.
Oh.
So it's wonderful. I shushed someone while they were in there. It was great.
How do you ask people how they're doing, though?
You don't. You don't talk. It's wonderful. You wouldn't be able to do it.
Doesn't sound like that's relaxing to me.
Yeah, that's the whole point. You go there, and they want to. You can't have your phones, no electronics, no nothing.
Oh, wow.
I was there for like 2.5 hours. Didn't speak a word.
Good for you. You got a little restore. Did you go see Doris Day's house?
Oh, yeah, we did.
Oh, good.
No, we didn't. Fuck that. Come on. Why would I go see Doris Day's house?
I don't know. I don't know why I did, but I did. Well, good. I'm glad you had a good weekend.
Yeah.
Did you do the 15-mile ride?
17-mile drive, yeah. Up near Pebble Beach. Yep, we did that.
No, was it hard in Carmel? Because it's a very ritzy area, so I'm sure that some male admirers were looking at you, and you had to, you weren't alone. How do you?
Oh, no, the apps were full of townies. It was rough.
Oh.
It was rough.
So I guess all the rich people that came in weren't gay or
no.
weren't interested.
It was very, you know what it was too? A lot of German tourists. A lot of German tourists they start in San Francisco and they take the whole California coastal trip. A lot of Germans, like especially went to Nepenthe or Nepenthe or whatever it is, a little restaurant in Big Sur. And it was like
that place is real fucking good.
Everyone was it looked like iffy to me. We didn't eat lunch.
Oh, I
either. It looked like sandwich food. We went somewhere else for me and the guy I'm seeing are snobs. I know that's shocking for people.
Shocking.
We had some picnic food sometimes. It was really lovely. Great weather.
Good.
Yeah.
I'm shocked you didn't fuck in the woods.
No, you get pine needles in places. No, I need to be if I'm not fucking on the edge of a fountain, up against a wall, or in a sling at Slammers, I need to be in a bed. I don't like the outdoors for that.
Wow. You know, Poods, you paint a picture. I'll give you that. You paint a picture.
Should we talk about the show now?
I think we talked
about our weekend. By the way, y'all, I will be doing a Big Brother corner next Sunday. It has started. I have things to say. I have thoughts. First of all, I did say this before. First of all, I believe there are this is a tinfoil hattie theory. I believe there are two Big Brother executive producers incognito in this these cast members.
Oh.
They seem fake. It seems like they're just like that red person, that's completely invented. And there's a woman named Blue.
I noticed that. They're like Taylor Swift albums.
I think this is all a joke. I think Blue is Leanne Rimes, sweetie.
Oh. I'd love to see that concert. I know every song.
Yeah.
You can try to resist, not to hurt from my kiss.
Don't combine Leanne Rimes albums and Taylor Swift albums in the same sentence. How about that? Because they're very different artists.
It's going to be sad for me. I'm going to Beyonce's birthday show at the same place, but I don't have VIP tickets there. I'm going to be right back. Oh, I will have to tell you, Sonny. I forgot to tell you a funny story. You will enjoy this. This is why I'm
Why not? We're already 15 minutes in.
Why not? I'm already bad about when friends that are... I don't really have a lot of famous friends. I don't really have any. I mean, maybe Karamo, and that's kind of
it. You mentioned
all
of them, though.
But there's probably a good reason, because... So I had to go to the bathroom. And when you go to the bathroom... you had to go down. We were on the first kind of level up, but you had to go down to the floor, and yeah. I had to walk on the floor. It was really crazy. They made me walk on the floor. Literally, I walked right by like Taylor's walkway. I was like 20 feet looking at Taylor just singing, trying to go to the bathroom. It was ridiculous. But anyway, so I'm going to the bathroom, and on the way back, I forget the area where Karamo and all the celebrities are.
Yeah.
You know the Instagram that you saw with, like, what's her name? Who's in all the Ryan producer films? The one
Ryan Murphy?
Yeah. What's her name? It was a video of her and like five other like famous white women all seeing Taylor Swift, and everybody was insta tweeting it.
Well, how old is she? Ryan Murphy has a lot of women.
The one who the one who's a lesbian and dating that other
Sarah Paulson.
Yes, it was Sarah Paulson and like I'd all these crazy famous people. So yeah. What that is, that's down on an air. It's actually not very good. You can't really see. It's
Can
down
we
by the floor.
Up?
Yeah. So, but anyway, that's where Cromo and Channing and Gail and all these other.
Yeah, we know them all by their first names.
Tay Tay's mom. That's where they all were. And so I walked by and I thought, oh, I just see my friend. I don't realize he's standing literally by Gail King.
And
so I just wave at Karamo. This security guard pushed me down and threw me out faster than I could say dick licking.
Now that's what I would have enjoyed.
Hogtied. And he was like, don't wave at the famous people, you dumb bitch.
Get out of here, peon.
I almost peed myself. I had to pee so bad. That was it. I meant to tell you that part.
Okay, thank you. Let's move on.
Let's talk about
Brandan and Mary. Is anybody else besides the roosters? Is anybody else concerned at her feeder habits? She wants him to be like a teddy bear so she can hug him like an 8-year-old girl.
This was one of the most bothersome things I've ever seen on 90 Day Fiancé, period. Full stop.
And y'all know how I feel about adults feeding adults. I'm repulsed by it.
Yeah.
It's not good.
More than adult braces?
That's a tough call, especially on you. No, adults feeding adults is a different kind of thing.
She kept feeding him because she wants him to... I'm just going to say this, y'all. Maybe I'm going to get flack for this, but I 100% 100%. I 100% think, and I don't mean this to be funny. I mean this in seriousness. If this couple stays together, that 6 years from now, Brandon goes missing.
This is the kind of person who this is a Dateline episode waiting to happen.
Yes, 100%.
Yeah, it's.
I don't feel safe.
There is mental illness here.
Yes.
There is also trauma here.
Yes.
And anyway, y'all, she did not sleep in the same room with him because he was hitting her in the face with his feet.
Mm-hmm.
But I think there was another reason. She's like, I'm just not comfortable. It's weird because now that he's here in person, it's different than I thought.
Yeah.
Yeah. That happens sometimes. Anyway, but Grandpa Lolo is going to teach him how to farm. And so I wrote down, so I guess this is his life now. This is what he does. He's going to move there to be a farmer with Mary. Anything else of his life is gone. He's just going to be on the farm.
But he didn't have much of a life. He was living, I mean, for again, he was living in, the, again, y'all, we look at this water field with cow manure and piss in it, and you think, oh, God, that's so horrible. But this is a stepping stone for him.
I don't know if it had piss in it.
He said it did.
But it's a rice field. It doesn't have to have poop in it.
Well, Brandon said it has poop and water. Yeah,
it's just mud.
It's poop water, y'all. Poop water.
I think it looked fine.
Would you step in it barefoot?
Absolutely not.
Because he did.
As soon as he did that, I went, hookworms, hookworms. When he put a foot in, I went, ooh, ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think Lolo is used to it.
But yeah.
Brandon's going to get hookworms, y'all. Anyway, Brandon seems to do okay out there with the, as they call it, the Carabao. So, again, we do. She's like, I've been learning how to be a real man through Lolo. And he's like, but real men don't keep secrets. So I think I need to tell him that we kissed at the airport. She's like, well, just tell him. Just tell him. It's like, we kissed, and she goes, we kissed, and translates, and silence. Well, I'm angry. They didn't ask for my blessing. But, well, he does give them permission, but he says, you need to get married to strengthen your relationship. Let's plan the wedding now. We'll schedule it. We'll put out a doodle poll.
A doodle poll. Check. What?
So make sure for all the relatives, and they'll get the doodle poll, and we'll schedule your wedding around Aunt Margie's foot surgery.
Foot surgery. What? Yeah. When hopefully not on a Thursday, because that's when she watches her program. What? Why didn't they say we kissed? I didn't know that I needed your blessing. Did he not say that because he didn't want to throw Mary under the bus, I guess?
I think she was trying to make sure Lolo understood that it was all him. And I think Brandon is being extremely diplomatic here.
Yeah.
He's bending over backwards. Not in the bed. Because
not in the bed. They can't do that. Mm-mm.
But yeah, mm-mm. I liked it how they immediately said, well, since you kissed, we got to get that wedding happening.
Imagine if you had to marry everyone you kissed.
Ooh. That's a lot of wedding gifts to return.
That court, that divorce court clerk would know you by sight unseen. Well, hey, Jay Bird, how you doing?
Just another one. Thanks, buddy. I find this whole thing about they need to get married right away and her persistence at this is the way things are in the Philippines and it's our culture. I find it to be awful, and I'm surprised there's not more Filipinos complaining about it.
Don't worry, our producer is. True. She's screaming. But it's very manipulative.
It's making them look like extremely backward culture.
It is.
Yeah.
It is.
Because you go to Manila, this is not the way.
No, this is the way. It is not the way at all.
So later on, we're wearing puka shells. I don't know where these
came
in.
They got some pukas. I noticed that,
evidently,
too.
There's a Hollister in their son.
An Airy.
An Airy.
Airy, that's like, that's a shop, Airy. It's a women's shop, I think.
I think puka shells come from like Hollister.
No, Airy, too. You just don't know Airy like back in the day.
I don't.
I think that's how you spelled? Pronounce it. Airy, A-E-R-I-E.
I've never heard of it, but if it's a women's shop, I would have no reason to go in there.
Well,
I do know Wet Seal.
Airy's part of, like, I think it's part of and owned by American Eagle.
Oh, that makes sense.
Because I got a lot of,
like, Aeropostale.
No. But they would have had it too. I got a lot of puka shells at American Eagle. Remember American Eagle when you had some big old bird on your chest on a polo?
Yes. And the shirts were all wrinkled up.
Yes.
That was a thing.
Yeah.
And they were so kind of big and like the boot cut and the tapered jeans.
Oh, boot cut. They were the clothing supplier for Gay Next.
They were. If you work for MTV, I need Gay Next from the vault. I need it like
too.
I need air.
Put that on Wow Presents Plus.
You can find. Boy, those were the early aughts in the 90s. You can find a couple episodes of gay contestants on the show Next when they went on the bus, and it is the you will sit there and it is. Good family and fam. Good family fun and entertainment.
We keep bringing it up because it needs to keep being said.
It needs to be said. So they're going to go to the beach to see the three friends. I'm just going to call them Miranda, Charlotte, and Samantha.
Well, actually, their names are Pudding or Puddin. Puddin. Yeah,
Pudding.
Pudding. And then Gello. And I can get the third one. Is it Gus?
I prefer Samantha, Miranda, and Miranda, or Miranda. Whatever, Charlotte.
Charlotte. It might as well be the same.
At least one of them is gay.
I think at least two of them are. And so all this talk of Mary hanging out with her guy friends, and I don't like it. I get jealous. I get jealous when she hangs out with those men and they talk about how they braided her hair or how they put on eyeshadow on her. Oh, a man's not going to do that to my woman.
Samantha's like, we like you, but we just don't like it that you don't let her hang out with us and Kiki. And he's like, well,
teaching her how to walk in high heels. Don't you do that to my woman.
Now that you know her, now that we know you, it's not as big deal. But they're like, so what are your plans? And this is what Brandon said this. And I went, holy shit. He's like, but you won't let me hang out with any guys even.
Any guys.
You're worried about their girlfriends or their mothers. Y'all. And it's almost like she heard him say it, and then she was kind of on camera, and you kind of see her trying to process the truth of it, but she can't. This is some real trauma that's happened. And like you said before, I don't feel safe with this storyline. I don't feel it's going to turn out well for Mary or for Brandan. Spoiler alert, it does seem like he's still there.
No, I'm telling you, I worry about her killing him. I'm not even kidding.
If something happens.
She could bury him in that water field and the water buffalo could walk over him and we'd never know.
And then she's like, well, she's like, why? He's like, why can you have friends and I can't? She's like, well, I've known Samantha, Miranda, and Charlotte for years.
And he falls, but I don't have any friends. I'm just trying to make friends, basically. And you go, oh, God.
So the gal pals basically say, but why do you want to get married now? It's just so fast.
And why do you get jealous of us? We're just girlfriends.
We need him to meet someone, or someone from the U.S. needs to come visit him, because I need to see her eyes fill with rage and vinegar.
Lose herself. Then the shadiest of the queens, Samantha, most likely, says, did you know, girl?
Also, Pudding.
Pudding. Did you know, girl, that Mary turned off her Wi-Fi and unplugged her phone? And one of the other queens went, girl! Still you shady!
Mary, did you know that you turned up your Wi-Fi and said you lost your router?
Now, y'all, she's like, no. Sometimes the power went out. You know, typhoons, these things happen.
Brandon's like, hasn't gone out yet while we've been here for like a week.
And then he's like, so maybe that's why you should know each other before you get married. I think that's probably Miranda. She's a little bit more level-headed. And she apologizes.
Well, kind of that's more of a Charlotte move.
Oh, okay.
But anyway.
And that's Charlotte.
Continue. Yeah.
Again, I don't watch the show. I know their names.
I know. Yeah.
She apologizes. Like, I just can't throw my friends away. And she makes it about her wanting to have friends.
It's so hard to be alone while my boyfriend was sleeping on the other side of the world. And I went, oh my God, who hurt you?
I have a feeling we'll find out. Maybe it was the parents who never loved her, who left her with the grandparents.
Yeah, something happened.
Or the ex-boyfriend who cheated on her, as she said, 10 times.
Yeah.
This storyline, it's not even that it makes me sad. You're exactly right. It makes me scared. I'm never secure when I'm watching it. Because I'm worried about what she's going to do next.
It's interesting because we always talk about how the American comes over, takes advantage of somebody who's in a lower kind of status or socioeconomic position. Ironically, Brandan is the one who has less power in this. And actually, Mary is the one that has all the power in this.
Yep. And she's gone mad with it. Should we talk about Kimberly and TJ?
Ooh, y'all. Settle in for this one.
What is your read on her yet? I go back and forth.
I'm seeing it's going to be a hurt people situation with her. I don't think there's this like... I don't think that she's at least what I'm getting, she's so self-involved. She doesn't realize that she's hurting people, but she also doesn't even realize she's self-involved. I think, again, this is somebody who, it's not mental illness per se, but I think someone who is going to come off in this edit as a really fucking entitled American. And she doesn't mean to be, but it's going to come off that way.
That's what I was going to say. I think she's going to get, by the end of this episode, by the end of this season, she's going to get a terrible edit. White women with an air of entitlement do not do well on The Other Way. Cross-reference with Ari. Danielle.
Who?
Yeah. Sorry, miserable bitch.
Okay.
Yeah. Or Dog the Bounty Hunter, as I called her later.
That's true. But I want to say that
hair is Dog the Bounty Hunter.
We haven't seen enough of Kimberly yet. I do think it's a little different with, I think, Miserable Bitch, I think, as literally doesn't care.
Yeah.
Doesn't care about hurting people.
I'm not really comparing her to that woman. I'm just saying.
But I know, I think you bring up a good point, though. We don't know enough about Kimberly. And Ari, again, has a self-absorption that borders on narcissism.
Yeah.
With Kimberly, I think for her, it comes from this place of, if I shut out all the bad in the world and make joyful YouTube videos where I'm dancing and wearing a onesie, nothing's going to hurt me. But her level of compromising and tolerating uncomfortableness is nil.
It's interesting because I feel like there's a storyline we're trying to tell with this of a kind of an Indian man who is going to kind of make his new bride fit in, but TJ keeps flipping the script from what they're trying to tell,
it's not going.
She's not Jenny. She's not naive like Jenny, and she's not Jen. These were both older women that we knew nothing could happen.
It doesn't help that TJ is going to be gaslighting the fuck out of her. And I mean that by gaslighting because he's not telling her anything of what's expected of her. Yeah, when she reacts to it, I think that's when he's going to gas. When she reacts and says, I don't want to do this, he's like, you're crazy for thinking
I have a bone to pick with that. And let me tell you why. She's been here for a year. She knows what's expected of her. She knows what's expected.
That's true. We forget that she came here for a year. I forget
she
about that.
She lived with them. She knows. That's why I'm saying this is producer initiated. I forget about that.
You feel like she's never been here before, but you're right.
No. Bitch knows the country. I will say this. Now, and also, are we supposed to believe had a conversation about this and what she's going to do on a daily basis?
So is it fraudacity?
Yeah, I think so. Now, if it's not, she is certainly dim because I think she knows.
She's been around the world and she wants her countertop and I don't
know. Now, here's the thing. If they've had a conversation where she said, I'm not going to be a regular Indian wife, I feel like that could have been interjected earlier.
Yeah.
Like, he knows that. She has played ignorant about that.
And if they had that conversation, he's playing, like, ignorant about it as well.
To me, it feels like fraudacity. You know, I'm going to venture something forward, and I hate what I'm saying. I can't believe I'm saying this.
No.
I don't think they have a lot of problems. Except for their both of the general unpleasantness towards the other.
And just screaming, going from 0 to 100 and just starting to scream at one another.
But I do feel, and I can't believe I'm saying this, I do feel TJ is a much more evolved Indian man to Western eyes than some of the other men that we've seen.
He's trying because they sit down and they go for a walk and have that conversation. And he's trying to, it's like they went and watched a couple of Instagram videos of like a Yonla Van Zandt or something. They're like, okay, I hear you. I'm going to try to change for you. I'm like, this isn't going to happen.
What did you think when he said he was talking about how his family felt? And she's like, well, this is between us. It's going to be between us, and that's what happens. And I'm like, you're living with
me. Yeah, I was going to ask you, Poodle, who does she live with?
And then the other thing is...
she lives with the family. It's going to be everybody. Can you imagine if you lived with Aunt Peggy or Aunt Darla in their house and you had a fight?
They're going to be involved.
Oh, yeah.
But what should happen is she should say, I want you to always... You are my greatest advocate in your household. You are, what you cannot do is shit talk me. You can't Chantel me to your family like you did before. You can't do that. Let's set this up.
The problem is, though, is that, I mean, they talk about this. We're kind of brushing over it, but it's all kind of, the only thing I feel like with this couple, y'all, I feel like we're not going to be going point by point a lot of times with this couple because I think it's going to be the same beat.
Round and around. Yeah.
Because they have this moment where you're right, though. It almost later when she says they have the party with his family. She has no idea what's going on.
And she sent mom a lovely text message to apologize, by the way. Best type of heartfelt apologies are through text.
Emoticons. She looks beautiful. The colors are really pretty on her. But they're talking.
It's like a Ganesh ceremony, y'all.
It is. But when they talk later, and it was like they have talked about this before when he was like, she's like, what's a day-to-day going to look like? And he was like, well, I'm a husband now, so I've got to make decisions. And you're going to get up and, you know, the women get up and do that. And she said, that's some shit I'm not going to do.
That's
and
he not
seemed
what
to accept
said.
It.
But that's not what he said, actually. I'm gonna clarify it. That's what they said in the clip, and that's not what was there.
No, it wasn't there at all.
What happened, he said, you know, the women, they do housework, they cook and clean, but you're not like that.
Yeah, that's what I meant to thank you for. It's like they had already talked about it before.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah. So I agree with on Fraudacity point, yeah.
I do want to say one thing that this Ganesha sent where the elephant god and you play music and you get the harmonium and your tabla and your drum and Ganesha's like, thank you for that. That's amazing. So it's like, you know, it's like when you play Chromatica for a twink and they're rolling on Molly. Ganesha is like, thanks, girl.
You know, I thought you were going to do something that was going to be teaching about culture or pretty, and you just made a gay twink joke.
Well, Ganesh was probably a twink in his younger years.
Probably, yeah. Honestly. No, Jesus.
I rolled down my hair. That Lady Gaga song about her hair is so bad.
I don't know that song.
Oh, come on. I love my hair.
No.
You've never heard that song?
No.
Oh, it is so stupid.
I think it would be too much for me, but after going to see Taylor, I think I would go see Lady Gaga just to see the atmosphere of it. I think it would be, I will say this, everyone was wearing pink and like I was wearing my Kennergy shirt and I'd walk by and people would be like, hi, Ken. And I would say, hi, Barbie. And like, it was so much of just, and like guys were wearing, you would have loved it. There were all these straight, this is going to really upset you. I'm sorry. There was a lot of really hot straight guys that were boyfriends and they were wearing shirts that said, fuck the patriarchy. And well, then there were like dads that had shirts that said, hi, it's me. I'm the problem. I'm dad.
That's cute. Have you ever been to like a mainstream like music event like this? Like people do this.
No, I've never been where people dressed in so much like cosplay. I've been to Shania concerts, but it's not the same because her heyday was earlier. Yeah. Well, and her, it's like past that, you know, now it's more nostalgic, not in the moment of it. We didn't get to go to like concerts.
Like a Madonna concert.
I've never been to a Madonna concert. Now, we were at the Spice Girls. We went to that. But again, it was more nostalgic. I've never been to a concert in the...
Though, because this is very niche. And people are making this kind of a... People are celebrating their own eras.
And I think like out of COVID, like I think when I do go to Beyonce, it's going to be... but that's going to be more about
someone's a high roller these days, aren't they?
No, the Beyonce tickets I bought from my friend, I think they're literally in the back row of the SoFi, and I bought four tickets for $400. So each only paid $100.
It's not bad.
No, but
I'm sure it'll be great.
There was a lot of hot guys and fuck the, why did I start talking about this? It was something to do with
we're never going to finish this show.
Just continue.
I was just wanted to say, she later goes shopping with the brother. Yash, who I think they look very much alike.
They do.
I'm kind of into both of them. Cool brother sandwich.
Stop. They're both attractive. TJ has a really beautiful smile.
They don't have to fuck each other. They can both fuck me. They don't even have to look at each other. It's not incestuous if it's a brother sandwich, right?
We need to move on. This isn't going to go well. We're going to get letters.
Anyway, so y'all, she kind of starts going off. She's wearing what I'd like to call a haughty headband.
She is.
Already, faulty. Y'all, you're going to get some shit out of her today.
Yeah.
He is fully prepared to unload with this headband. It's already bringing that energy.
I don't like it when you say that sentence.
What? Unload?
Yeah. Yeah, I don't use that word.
Prepare to unload.
Stop!
We don't unload on you, boy.
No.
Mm-mm. So, it's interesting. It somehow gets into talking about what she does and what she's expected to do to live here. And she's like, I mean, if I want to eat garlic more than one time in a week, I have to ask someone. That's invasive of my culture. And I understand why she's upset about that. It seems like that is part of their religious belief. And for Hindus, your diet is ingrained with religion. And the thing about it is, I assume she is converting to Hinduism.
We don't know. Has to be, though.
And it seems like she would just be expected to, because that's the way these people live, the family lives, and they are vegetarian. She's like, well, maybe I want to go eat. And this is when I feel like she's just testing boundaries with this guy.
You're moving here, girl. Like, why are you sitting here saying, but I'm American, I make my own choice, you're taking my freedom, my right? And I'm like, you're moving to another country. Like,
this is someone who's probably not awful getting a bad edit.
Yeah.
I agree with you. I don't think she's probably a bad person. They're using all of the worst material for her.
Yeah.
Because she's so good at it.
She's so good at it, because they're going to do this, and then next week they're going to show her being awful, and then cut to her having to do like a tarot read and trying to be all like universe and
spirit. I'm going
to
say this now. I think these two are going to be fine. I just have a feeling. I know we said DOA on this before.
We did say so, but now that you're talking about Fraudacity vibes,
yeah,
I kind of agree.
I also think... Then it becomes a tradition off who's sacrificing the most.
Yeah.
And y'all, no one wins at this. It's not helpful. And she comes off as looking really small when every time you have to say, do you know how much I've sacrificed and what I had to go through?
She does.
And I will say, y'all, for that mother to give up the idea of an Indian daughter-in-law, can you imagine that?
That's a lot. Because you can tell the mother, she even says, or she's like, it's just her face. She looks unhappy all the time. And she does.
Yeah. That's all I've got. I'm going to... It's going to be interesting to see how Kimberly interacts with social media after this.
She looks like an Emily.
She kind of looks like an Emily. Look at that. Dog the Bounty Hunter and Johan.
Now listen, I'm pretty sure that cow smiled at me, right, Lizette?
Oh my God. Oh my God, it's charging at me. It's charging at me.
No, it's just walking, Lizette. Oh my God. It's just charging. Just the like harmless.
Poop? There's poop?
No, that's the harmless animals. Look,
you know what? You don't know. You don't know. It's like it's like I could have gotten hit by a bus.
Hey, what are you? I'm a New Yorker. You're a typical New Yorker. Yeah,
I'm a New Yorker too, and I'm not used to cows.
I'm just saying, he smiled at me. He smiled at me.
How big would we think that guy's dick is?
Goon, goon, goon. These women are putty in Johan's hand.
Y'all, as soon as one of our sissies sent me or put it on our Facebook group, maybe, it's like, said his dick touched Lisette's leg, and immediately she was changed.
Oh.
It's like it made her docile.
Oh, Johan.
Like, she was changed, like being touched by a magic wand.
It's true, y'all. It's true. Let's talk about Miserable Bitch and Johan and Sandra and Lizette. I want these two women to just travel around the world and meet. Like, can they just go and meet other casts? Like, go around different countries?
They're auditioning for Pillow Talk. Yeah, this is a 100% Pillow Talk audition. Yeah.
100%.
They'll be on the tell-all. Because, you know, what's her name? Randy and Jen were doing Pillow Talk.
Oh, they were. I did not know that.
It makes sense, right?
Now, I guess we don't know by the time if they're going to be striking whenever they do the toe tell-all, if it's going to be Sean Robinson or not, do we?
Who knows?
She's definitely not on the B90.
No. Okay. Because they filmed it.
Who knows? All right.
So I think Johan's like basically says, we're going swimming in the pool. And they go, yay!
Like, yeah, whatever you want, Johan.
He like said book English and like, good job.
Yay. Your dick is huge.
They bring up this kid conversation. Of course, did you see their faces when Johan's or Daniel says, well, he has to try to have a kid every night. And they're all like,
that's a lot of work.
A lot of work.
That's why I immediately flash back. I'm like, I do believe her going to a fertility expert, a doctor, and the chance was they could only get pregnant was 5% via natural sex.
Yes.
I guess she's forgotten about that. She's like, well, I'll proceed to get railed every night. Not just railed, pummeled.
Well, I think it went up 7% whenever she planted that banana tree.
Yeah, that's true.
Don't forget that. And then all the locals took
like a,
it
like
they needed food.
Like a pestle into a mortar.
Yeah.
Goom, 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 goom.
Doom, doom. I don't know. She's got a rude awakening because, y'all, this woman came to live on vacation and avoid a bankruptcy. And instead, she's about to have a kid and she thinks that her life's going to be easy after that.
Well, she also says that, you know, it's a shame. I raised a son. This was the most amazing statement, and I need to read it verbatim. Well, I don't know. Was I ready for a kid at 21 when I was in community college? Love the incidental backstory drop.
Yeah.
There, honey. Oh, you struggled.
Oh.
You struggled. We all have, honey.
We, yeah.
I went as soon as I heard it. Right now I have enough energy for two kids, but I know I don't know how much longer I'm going to have it. And then she says, and Johan's like, well, God is the only one who sends children. And you got to fuck every day for them.
Like, you're going to fuck every day for it.
But she's like, I think the smartest thing is to go the medical route. And the two friends are like, where are you getting the money for it?
Yeah, they're both kind of like, well, that's expensive. And you know they say it because they both said, well, and he's had two jobs, so I'm worried about that. But you know they also say when they leave the camera, and how the fuck is Danielle going to pay for that? She's got all those. You know, they know. Yeah. They know.
This is, y'all, this is all fantasy. This storyline is 100% fantasy. Mm-hmm. They got a dog. That's all they're going to have. I'm saying it now. I can't believe Danielle actually wants to do IVF.
I kind of I'm surprised. I think she's saying that, but it's going to be too hard. She's trying to show Johan that she's trying to do it. But eventually it's going to be, well, you're right, Johan. We'll just leave it up to God and she's never going to get pregnant.
Yep, exactly.
And she'll just get fucked every night trying.
You know what? It's not a bad situation when you think about it. She's kind of a genius. She's in her zone of genius, as her Instagram thing said. Y'all, you've got to find that. It's her.
Sissies have sent us to it. Oh, I don't need to see stuff about her, but y'all send it to us anyway. But
I'm every ethnicity in the world except Hispanic.
And she's a genius. You guys, if someone calls... If someone calls himself a genius... they're an asshole.
We also find that Johan was a 12-pound baby.
There you go.
Which I believe because his dick is now 12 pounds.
Yeah, it is. I don't know what is involved in worrying about your pH level.
Flora and fauna.
I do enjoy alkaline water. I'm not going to lie. It does help my reflux.
I'm not going to quibble with saying that her internal, you know, pH, her bacteria, but flora, your body's flora is like in your digestive system, your probiotics. Yes. Fauna is animal life.
Okay,
I
that's
know what
okay.
she's got living in that coochie.
It's that animal dick.
Are there like many like horses?
That it might as well be. I saw the OnlyFans.
Little sea monkeys. Anyway, I also liked her saying, you know, I raised a son in the I raised my son in the States, and I wonder if there's going to be things for him like soccer and t-ball and music classes.
Because we're just here on this just remote little you know un
this little hellhole.
This is hell. This just yeah uncivilized island.
I also wrote down her talking heads. She's giving with her hair element and her necklaces. It's giving very fortune teller.
Does seem like she's going to tell a fortune. That's all I have.
This is such a joke season for her. Like, it is. She's a laughingstock this season. God. Yeah. Miserable bitch. Julio and Kirsten, how can this guy get worse?
Oh, boy. Boy.
Wow.
Wow. I have a theory.
And I think she knows it, and she nailed it. Julio, of course, she says, he's like, I've always wanted to live outside the U.S., but everyone's reaction is kind of making me feel like I was rash about the decision. And I. So what happened was, he's a selfish asshole. I said, if you wanted to live abroad, go do it. Don't meet a woman and say, hey, mom, this chick is pulling me off. You know, I got to go where my heart goes.
I will say, though, from a producing standpoint, I agree with everything you just said. He's coming off as an asshole. And I'm not trying to blame the edit here. It's more about the producing. I am confused. Like, when we meet him, he's presented as this world traveler. And he even said it this episode, I always want to live in other countries. So I don't know if it's for audacity, but it just feels weird because the edit of the first like two episodes was, I'm a world traveler. Yeah. I want to live abroad.
Who do we believe?
But now he doesn't want to live abroad, and he wants her to like, and he doesn't want to move because of fucking hot dogs.
Here's no pizza.
Or pizza.
I like when she's like, you can go to Italy. You can take a train to Italy for pizza. He's like, it's not the same.
No, it's better.
And I will say Italian pizza is different. New York pizza is a very specific thing. But to be talking that you don't want to leave, America because you're worried you can't get your shitty diner's French toast, I think you've got a couple more issues.
So I still feel like we don't know all the secrets of this. Either we don't know the cup or they don't have problems and this is fraudacity.
Yeah, I don't know why we're telling the story the way we are, though, because obviously it makes everyone at home go, Julio is a douche.
I mean, I could see them doing this because I don't think Kirsten is like super she's so contained, and so on reality TV,
she ain't interesting. Yet.
She's not interesting.
Dutch ice princess. Yeah,
but man, this guy. I'm like, what's going to be your excuse next week not to leave?
Right. And this idea of, she even said it. She's like, you're just coming up with the little excuses. She nails him to the board and says, you're just coming up with excuses. So, you know, little things to not go. And that's when he keeps saying, these other little things I'm going to miss about the U.S. And he's like, so you can't see yourself living here at all? If I would have been her, I would have said, what the fuck is your problem? I would have flipped the table and said, we're on the other way. I'm on tow. See these cameras? You're going with me. That's what you signed up for, you asshole. I don't give a fuck about you and your French toast. You're going to come over and you're going to eat strope waffles with me for the rest of your life.
That's why you aren't on TV.
But that's what I would have done.
I don't blame you. I don't blame you. I agree. You're right.
I would have flipped the fucking table.
You would have.
And I cannot believe we missed this irony. She says, what's this on top of these eggs, this eggs Benedict that she got, or this kind of like smoked salmon Benedict that she's got? He's like, oh, that's hollandaise. She's like, oh, weird, like mayonnaise. And I was like, the irony of you asking what hollandaise is and you're from Holland. And no one got it. And I'm sitting here screaming.
I just assumed that hollandaise was invented there.
I don't know I think the history of hollandaise has very little to do with Holland. I'm not sure. I don't know the history of that sauce.
God.
We could have made a joke. Yeah. We could have made a joke about it. They could have done a talking head saying, do you know what hollandaise is? But you're from Holland. She's like, I don't know. I don't know what something like weird when I, something, it tastes weird. When she says weird, it tastes weird. But there was something about her not knowing what hollandaise was, even though she's from there.
Yeah.
And I went, irony is dead. Anyway, I think he needs to leave this woman alone, use this attempt to break up with her, and she needs to go back to the Netherlands. He can go fuck some other towny girl from Long Island. But you know what? They've probably all fucked him. That's why he has to date internationally. Because all of them know that he's a complete D-bag. Sorry, that was a rant. The hollandaise thing really threw me.
Still hit it. He's still cute.
You, okay.
I know.
Even knowing everything you know.
Yeah, I know.
And he, think how terrible he would talk to you.
Don't give me a good time right now, Poodle. Don't make me think of it. That's all I got.
Can you make this over there? What? I can't go. What? I can't look in the joy of cooking and find like, some shitty diner food.
You can just make fucking French toast. What last question though about this before we move on? Is there a country you would not move to
because
they don't have good pizza?
There's a lot of bad pizza in the world.
Imagine, imagine he could be wealthy. He could be beautiful. He could have an 8-inch dick, but his country, you would never get good pizza again.
What do you mean by good? Like, did it taste like Totino's?
It would taste like Sbarro's whenever it's been left out for about 4 hours and they reheat it.
I'm kind of okay with that. I don't.
Oh, wow.
I have a. Like, the thing is, good pizza is like a five.
It's cafeteria lunch room pizza.
But that's nostalgia. I kind of miss that.
God, like, here's a pizza.
Here's a pizza that's not good. I had pizza in China that was literally tomato sauce and cheese that wasn't melted all the way. It was rough. Maybe China. But a lot of places, they have Italian restaurants in almost every nation. So you can get decent pizza everywhere. He's full of it. If he wants New York style pizza, that's going to be harder to find. But he's full of it.
He's full of it. All right, let's talk about Kenny and Armando. By the way, y'all, if you have not seen Kenny's amazing takedown in defense of his husband Armando online, you're missing
Girl, I clutched my pearls.
That's what you do when you love somebody, y'all. You take up for them.
And this is when he was talking about Hannah being there, because a lot of people in the comments were like, I would have never talked that way in front of my child. He's like, well, sometimes we can't make – what it was basically the argument was like, sometimes we can't do that, and my husband was doing the best he could.
Sometimes conversations come up.
Happen.
The woman's name was Karen, and Kenny started with, hi, Karen. That's an appropriate name.
But you know what? He was quite kind.
He was very kind. That's Kenny's gift. He's kind with just a hint of shade.
Yep, that's like me.
No, you're a bitch.
Kind bitch?
You know what? I am kind. I'm just going to be horrible about it. I'm going to be shitty to you.
Y'all process that statement. There's not a lot. Basically, he and his mom go to dinner and they just kind of, he tells her, you know, how he didn't feel supported and that not only was it hard for him, but he talks about being, y'all remember, like we talked about last week, he talks about even
trigger warning.
Trigger warning here. Suicide. He talks about how he felt suicidal after trying to pray the gay away.
I don't think we'd heard that before.
I feel like he did talk about that in his season. I thought I remembered that, right. But maybe not.
And he said, but Hannah was the one who kept me alive, and then I started crying.
It was very sweet.
And this was super fucking moving. And then mom finally says, this kind of let loose something in me. Mom said, I'm sorry. I love you. I didn't know it was that so dire for you. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. And I wonder if a lot of...
She was sobbing.
Yeah. I wonder if a lot of kids who grow up, queer kids who grew up, I can't have just begged or have wished for that time one of their parents could say, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry about that. I think kids and parents in general, even straight,
yeah,
a lot of, it's very hard for your parent just to say,
even as an adult.
Yeah.
But I think about my mom said, well, I'm sorry you had such a hard time as, you know, growing up that way. But it wasn't, you've talked about your mom said, well, I did the best I could.
Yeah.
You know, mm-hmm. it was never what we would have asked for.
Well, that's really, I'm so sorry, honey. Look at this new knitting pattern I found up on Etsy. Isn't this cute? Yeah, mom.
But I was thinking about how much that would mean to me.
If
my mom had said, I'm so sorry. Not, she didn't have to cry, you know, the way his mom said it, I could tell she wasn't trying to distance herself from it. And so I was very moved by that moment.
And it's hard when you're a parent because you know, everybody says, I do the best I can and all that. And you don't mean to, obviously, most parents don't mean to put any type of hurt or feel like they neglect their child. But that's just going to happen. You can't be there for your child in all ways. So no, it's not your fault, but there is that line of like, there's a difference of a parent saying, I'm so sorry that happened to you. And then a parent saying to a child, I'm so sorry that I wasn't able to be there for you like I wanted to be. I am sorry.
Which is a very different thing. And all you have to do is, you said, you don't have to qualify it with, I was doing the best I could. It's not necessary.
Just for a parent. It was beautiful. So
just saying, I'm sorry. I didn't know what you were going through. And I wish I could have supported because that means the world. Just someone saying, I'm sorry for how you felt and that you felt alone.
Well, that's when you say, I'm so sorry you had that experience, or I'm so sorry you felt that way. That makes you feel okay, but it still makes you feel like you're at an arm's length, that you're othered a little bit. But when someone says, I'm sorry that I let you down, I'm so sorry. That makes you feel like they are sharing your pain.
I totally agree. It's just a very hard thing for a lot of people to do. Like, I'm sorry I let you down. I guarantee you my mother could not say that to me.
Oh, never.
Yeah.
That's the show. That's all we got.
Guess I need to make an extra therapy appointment this week.
Y'all use that BetterHelp codes /realitygaze. Believe me, Poodle and I are.
You get a discount.
You get a discount for your first month. It's very helpful. Very helpful. All right, everybody. This
you
is a good
better get better help.
Yeah, better get better help. All right, everybody. Thank you so much. A good episode. We're about to record 90 Day UK. We're excited. That was we get a new couple alert for 90 Day UK this week.
With a hot Argentinian guy.
God, 90 Day is bringing the hot guys. This
between him, Razvan, and I can count Julio, but he's just such a piece of shit.
If it was 11 o'clock and Julio sent you a girthy dick pic, would you say yes to it?
You know, it's hard because it would be hard.
What if he brought pizza?
That Goebbels could come through my door with a dick pic and pizza. I'm powerless. I don't care who you are. It's too much to resist, and none of you would either. If you come, through there, you send me a huge dick pic and you bring me a pizza pie.
I don't care if you got a horse face. Poodle's going to bone you.
I don't care.
That's the show, everybody. Go to realitygaze.com. Wow. That's where you can find everything about us. Hey, leave a review on Apple Podcasts or Spotify. Write something. Leave 5 stars. Write something kind. And if you don't know what to write, Poodle, what can they write?
Keep going, Queens.
Yes, y'all. H-E-Q. Keep going, Queens. Keep going, Queens. We love you out there. All right, everybody. We'll see you next week. We call these people Lonely Hearts because aren't we all just lonely hearts looking for love in all the wrong places?
Yes. And if you have ever had a kid right in the middle of community college at 21 without a steady income. In fact, you had him in the middle of the accounting class. You persevered. You didn't know what you were doing to raise a child. But you got there. And then 4 bankruptcies later, look where you are.
Y'all call us.
Call us.